Good evening, friends. The Supreme Court contempt judgment on Mathews Nedumpara was uploaded today afternoon. Okay, it says suo motu contempt petition CRL number 1 of 2019. So Mathews Nedumpara has the dubious distinction of being number 1 of 2019, and we are nearly 3 months through the year. Here we are, the order. Now let's just read the order. There are 2-3 parts to this order. It's quite interesting. And some others have also gotten involved now in the contempt. Advocate Nilesh, Ojha, and the Indian Bar Association. I read the complaint letter that they had written to Chief Justice of India. So Indian Bar Association and some other parties who wrote to Chief Justice of India, wrote a complaint to Chief Justice of India, which was reported in social media. I don't know if that they mean only by me or by others also. These people also find themselves facing a contempt notice, and they have to reply to this notice within 2 weeks. So here we are reading the judgment of Supreme Court. Order: by a judgment dated 12th March 2019 in National Lawyers Campaign for Judicial Transparency and Reforms and Others versus Union of India and Others, writ petition C number 191 of 2019, this bench held that Mathews Nedumpara advocate has committed contempt in the face of the court. This was saying the words Fali Nariman. In the interest of justice, however, notice was issued to Sri Nedumpara as to the punishment to be imposed upon him for committing contempt in the face of the court. Sri Nedumpara appeared today before us both by himself and through advocate Sri Subhasja. In the morning session, he appeared by himself. In the morning session, Sri Nedumpara did his best to see that the matter was not heard by this bench. He informed us that a transfer petition was filed asking the Chief Justice of India to transfer this case from this bench to some other bench. He also stated that he was going to file an application for recall of our order dated 12th March 2019. He cited Latin maxims and said that justice must be seen to be done. He also referred to the famous Rex versus Sussex justice case and referred generally to the fact that relatives of judges should not be seen practicing in the same court. He later asked the bench to grant a passover of his matter, inasmuch as his lawyer Sri Subhasja was on his way from Mumbai. He had not reached. The bench agreed and placed the matter at 2 p.m. At 2 p.m., Sri Jha came and addressed us and pointed out sections 14(1) and 2 of the Contempt of Court Act, together with section 479 of CRPC. He also made various other submissions, which the court reminded him were not on the punishment aspect of this case. So the conviction has already happened. I'm just interjecting here. As you know, conviction has happened in the previous judgment itself of the writ petition. This case was only about the punishment. You know, the show cause was only about the punishment. I don't know how you can really argue. Can you say, no, I should not get 6 months, I should get 3 months, or I should not get 3 months, I should get 1 week? I don't know how that can be argued, the punishment aspect. Maybe advocates would know better. So anyways, the judgment says, the court reminded him, he made various submissions which the court reminded him were not on the punishment aspect of this case. He continued, however, arguing as if he were arguing a review petition in open court. While Sri Jha was arguing, Sri Nedumpara stepped in again and went on a long ramble as to how he had not, in fact, impersonated Justice Wazifdar, which is one of the many incidents referred to in our judgment dated 12th March 2019. So now this was, of course, not in the face of the court, but as I said, a lot of incidents, a lot of the previous conduct of Mathews Nedumpara has been cited in that judgment, which one would, at least from my perspective as a common man, it looks as if it is there to add weight to the first thing, which first offense, which is saying Fali Nariman. So he, it seems Mathews Nedumpara was accused of impersonating Justice Wazifdar. That is, he is accused of phoning somebody, phoning a party and saying, I am Justice Wazifdar and Mathews Nedumpara is sitting in front of me and I want you to call me back as quickly as possible or tell your client to call me back, something like that. This is the allegation against him, for which a contempt notice was issued by Bombay High Court, I think in 2012 or 2013. And that case was never heard. So till date, it has not been heard by Bombay High Court. So Sri Nedumpara stepped in and went on a long ramble as to why, as to how he had not, in fact, impersonated Justice Wazifdar. Now, this Justice Wazifdar impersonation thing, I have noticed in my conversations with Mathew Nedumpara, hangs very heavy, unduly heavy, on Matthew's mind. I mean, from my perspective, he gives way too much weightage to it than it warrants. It is, in any case, sub judice. He's got some very strong evidence that would exonerate him. So I fail to see why he keeps agitating the point again and again. He's done that even in private conversations. He seems to return to this impersonation of Justice Wazifdar thing as if it is an allegation that really hurts him. I'm sure it hurts him, but I feel he is giving it undue amount of importance. Anyways, so it seems he went on a long ramble as to how he had not in fact impersonated Justice Wazifdar. At this stage, Sri Nedumpara then tendered an apology to this court by way of an affidavit duly signed by him in our presence. Now the affidavit reads as follows. Affidavit, I, Mathews J. Nedumpara, advocate, aged 60 years. Okay, so just let me, before I read the affidavit. So, Nedumpara, before tendering the affidavit, seems to have first said that he wants to have the thing heard by a different bench. And I think that was not successful. Then, in that way, there seem to have been several, you know, stages to this whole hearing. But this seems to be, to my mind, a kind of a final stage. To me, it appears like a capitulation. The affidavit reads, I, Mathews J. Nedumpara, advocate, aged 60 years, Indian inhabitant, residing at Harbour Heights, W Wing, blah, 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 now in Delhi. So he is in Mumbai, of course, he resides in Mumbai. So now in Delhi, do hereby swear and state as follows. A bench of this honorable court comprising Honorable Sri Justice Roington F. Nariman and Honorable Justice Vineet Saran, by judgment and order dated 12th March 2019, was pleased to hold me guilty for contempt in the face of the court and list the case for hearing on the question of punishment. I happen to mention, now this is the part where he's coming clean, or I feel he's apologizing. I happen to mention the name of Sri Fali S. Nariman to buttress my proposition that even the legendary Sri Fali Nariman is of the view that the seniority of a lawyer should be reckoned from the date of his enrollment and nothing else. However, I was misunderstood. I, along with some office bearers of National Lawyers Campaign for Judicial Transparency and Reforms, have instituted writ petition number 2199 of 2019 in the High Court of Delhi for a declaration that explanation to Rule 6 of the Bar Council of India is void, inasmuch as it explains that the word court does not mean the entire court, but the particular court in which the relative of a lawyer is a judge. I instituted the said petition only to raise the concern many lawyers share with me regarding the immediate relatives practicing in the very same court where their relative is the judge. Now, this part is, I feel, 100% valid. It is indeed a huge concern. If anything obstructs the administration of justice, the presence of immediate relatives practicing in the very same court where their relative is a judge obstructs the administration of justice. So I'm happy that Mathews Nedumpara has mentioned it in this affidavit. However, he says, in retrospection, I realize it was an error on my part to have arrayed Sri Fali Nariman as a respondent to the said petition. Now, when he says this, was he arrayed? Was Fali Nariman arrayed as a respondent to the said petition? I don't know, because I didn't read Fali Nariman's name in that petition. Let me see if I can quickly find it. But I don't remember seeing Fali Nariman as arrayed as a respondent in the said petition. But whatever it is, be that as it may, I regret the same. No words can sufficiently explain my contrition and regret. I also, in retrospection, realize that I have erred, even during the conduct of the above case before this honorable court, and I probably would not have kept up to what is expected of me as a lawyer in the bar for 35 years and crossed the age of 60. I feel sorry. Now, I have a feeling that all this has been included at the advice of his lawyer. You have to make a lot of placatory noises to placate the... I'm going to use this word, placate the ego of the judge. I think this is the kind of thing I often receive advice of this kind. So he writes, I probably would not have kept up to what is expected of me as a lawyer in the bar for 35 years and crossed the age of 60. I feel sorry, express my contrition and tender my unconditional apology while maintaining that some of the accusations leveled against me in the judgment dated 12th March 2019 are absolutely wrong, which are ex facie, black and white, and as incontrovertible as day and night. Okay. The apology tendered by me here and above be accepted and I may be purged of the contempt. So he has apologized, but of course he has definitely held his own. That's a good thing. I don't know how. Maybe this was not abject enough for the Supreme Court to feel that he had truly apologized. Anyways, so the judgment says, we have considered the affidavit so filed in the light of the incidents that have taken place in the Bombay High Court as well as this court. Given the fact that Sri Nedumpara now undertakes to this court that, now this must have happened verbally, that they must have said, okay, you will not go to jail, but provided you will never browbeat the court, do you undertake? Must have said, yes, my lord. Something like that must have happened in the hearing. So given the fact that Sri Nedumpara now undertakes to this court that he will never again attempt to browbeat any judge, either of this court or of the Bombay High Court. We sentence Sri Nedumpara to 3 months imprisonment, which is, however, suspended. Only if Sri Nedumpara continues in future to abide by the undertaking given to us today. In addition, Sri Nedumpara is barred from practicing as an advocate before the Supreme Court of India for a period of 1 year from today. So this is like, get out of this classroom and don't come back till the next class, something like that. This disposes of the punishment aspect of the contempt that was committed in the face of the court. Now, this is the first part that is over, or shall we say the second part that is over. Okay, now there is one more part in this judgment. This is where others have come into the picture. And Supreme Court has taken cognizance of the social media. Now, I wonder what they are taking cognizance of. Whether they are taking cognizance of my videos, whether they are... This was circulated elsewhere in other things. So anyway, they are taking cognizance of social media. That's the important thing. So this is the other part of this judgment. A letter dated 23 March 2019 received by the office of the judges of this bench on 25th is a letter that is sent to the President of India, Chief Justice of India and Chief Justice of High Court of Bombay by the President of the Bombay Bar Association and the President of Bombay Incorporated Law Society. Okay, now this is interesting. President of Bombay Bar Association and President of Bombay Incorporated Law Society complained against the Indian Bar Association, IBA, that is Advocate Vijay Kurle and Advocate Nilesh Ojha and others. Okay, so they complained against the Indian Bar Association, and it said, the aforesaid letter states, okay, we have come across in the social media copies of the following complaints purportedly made against Honorable Mr. Justice R.F. Nariman and Honorable Mr. Justice Vineet Saran, Judges Supreme Court of India. A complaint made with Your Excellency Secretariat by one Indian Bar Association dated 20th March 2019 bearing grievance number this. The first complaint through one advocate Mr. Vijay Kurle against sitting judges of the Honorable Supreme Court of India, the Honorable R.F. Nariman and the Honorable Mr. Justice Vineet Saran, seeking permission. Now this the complaint that was written sought permission to prosecute the learned judges, and it also sought withdrawal of judicial work from them for having passed a judgment dated 12th March 2019 convicting Mr. Mathews Nedumpara for having committed contempt of the Honorable Supreme Court of India. It has been addressed to Your Lordship, the Honorable Chief Justice of India, and copy thereof has been endorsed to Your Lordship, the Honorable Chief Justice, Bombay High Court. Now, this complaint, there is another complaint made by one Mr. Rashid Khan Pathan, who is said to be the National Secretary of Human Rights Security Council. Okay, this must be some NGO. Seeking similar directions and permissions against the Honorable Mr. Justice R.F. Nariman and Mr. Vineet Saran for having passed another order in another matter. Okay, so this was for a different order, a different matter. Okay, interesting. This has been addressed to Your Excellency, Your Lordship, the Honorable Chief Justice of India. Copies of these purported complaints have been circulated in the social media, annexure 1 and annexure 2. Fine. So someone, Indian Bar Association, and someone else, Rashid Khan Pathan. Fine. The prayers made in the complaint filed by Indian Bar Association are as follows. Taking action. Action to be taken under section 218, 201, blah, blah, blah. Read with 120B and 34 of IPC against Justice Rohington Fali Nariman and Justice Vinit Saran. Now, this of course brings us to a real anomaly. It becomes a kind of an ajuba. Okay. Indian Penal Code, if you have to take action under Indian Penal Code, IPC sections have to be registered against Supreme Court judges, then who will try them? A magistrate. So, the IPC sections will be laid down by, will it be a private complaint? Will a magistrate then, is an FIR going to be registered against Fali Nariman, Rohington Nariman and Vinit Saran? For passing order of willful disregard, disobedience and misinterpretation of law laid down by the Constitution. So it does create a kind of an anomaly. So obviously, I don't think anybody who wrote this, the people who wrote the letter were unrealistic enough to believe that these remedies are available to them. But I think they wrote it because they wanted to agitate this point. They keenly feel that this was an unjust judgment, and I think in order to agitate it, how else do they air their grievance against this? So they wrote to President of India, etc., etc. Anyways, so the consequences are here for us to see. This letter asked for immediate direction be passed for withdrawal of all works from Justice Rohington Fali Nariman and Justice Vinit Saran as per in-house procedure, etc., etc. Then there are other reliefs were sought. Directions to be given to Fali Nariman and Vinit Saran to resign forthwith, following the direction of a constitution bench in K. Veeraswamy versus Union of India and others. Incapacity, fraud on power and offences against administration of justice are ex facie proved. These are some very interesting phrases, especially fraud on power. I read this complaint on YouTube. Applicant be awarded sanction to prosecute Justice Rohington Fali Nariman under section 218-201 blah 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 of Indian Penal Code. Now, a lot of case law. The prayers made in the complaint filed by Human Rights Security Council are as follows. They're very similar. Very similar. Action to be taken under 218-201, blah, blah, Indian Penal Code, etc., etc. So, okay. Now, these two things look extremely similar. It looks like a copy-paste. Okay. So, it can be seen, the judgment says, it can be seen on a comparison of the prayers in both the complaints that they are substantially similar, showing that prima facie the aforesaid Vijay Kurle and Sri Rashid Khan Pathan are acting in tandem. Okay, interesting. It's possible that Rashid Khan Pathan copied Vijay Kurle's complaint or vice versa without necessarily having met him, but whatever. Also, the complaints are dated 20th March 2019 and 19th March 2019. So, there is a lot of similarity. Yeah, quite possible. Yeah. Bombay Bar Association and Bombay Incorporated Law Society. Now, all this is inside within the complaint filed to the Chief Justice by Bombay Bar Association and Bombay Incorporated Law Society. And they are saying, okay, now these guys are going up against Mathews Nedumpara also. Bombay Bar Association and Bombay Incorporated Law Society are going up against Nilesh Ojha and Mathews Nedumpara. So it says, the Bombay Bar Association and Bombay Incorporated Law Society have reason to believe that Mr. Nilesh Ojha and Mr. Mathews Nedumpara are in tandem with one another. Oh boy. Okay. This was instituted as the various acts. The criminal petition number 3 of 2017, which was instituted as a result of various acts of Nilesh Ojha and his associates, Mr. Nedumpara also appeared for one of the contemners. So they are making out a case for the two of them having being acting in tandem. Fair enough. Interesting. The timing of at which these complaints have been made after the bench comprising R.F. Nariman and Vinit Saran held Mathews guilty of contempt, and also the content of the complaint of Indian Bar Association make it apparent that these complaints are made to browbeat the court for having initiated contempt proceedings. Okay, so now Nilesh Ojha is also part of this browbeating the court. That is, it's getting very interesting. So the number of browbeaters is getting very interesting. It is pertinent to note that the standing committee, managing committee of all the three bar associations attached to the Bombay High Court being Bombay Bar Association, Advocates Association of Western India, and Bombay Incorporated Law Society. Passed resolutions appreciating and welcoming the judgment dated 12th March 2019 of the Honorable Supreme Court of India. So now we have even further divisions within the advocates community. Three bar associations attached to Bombay High Court, that is Bombay Bar Association, Advocates Association of Western India, and Bombay Incorporated Law Society, passed resolutions appreciating and welcoming the judgment holding Mathews Nedumpara in contempt. Very interesting indeed. Okay, so the entire lawyers fraternity is now, and I'm talking about not just the senior counsels, but now the law fraternity or the rank and file of advocates are now, they stand clearly divided, because you would be having the followers of Nilesh Ojha and Vijay Kurle. I don't know how many followers they have, but they have a large number, it seems. I would not be very sure. Mathews Nedumpara's that group NLC National Lawyers Campaign for Transparency and Reforms has claimed about 14,000 advocates, first generation lawyers, as members, and then this. Now they are rift there. There's a huge rift between them. Very interesting. Okay, so now they have to explain, they have to give show cause notice. We therefore issue show cause notice of contempt to Shri Vijay Kurle, Shri Rashid Khan Patan, Shri Nilesh Ojha, and Shri Mathews Nedumpara again to explain as to why they should not be punished for criminal contempt of Supreme Court, returnable within 2 weeks from today. So they will now, and there is one more trial coming up. There are one more proceedings coming up. Given the serious nature of the allegations leveled against this bench, the Chief Justice of India to constitute an appropriate bench to hear and decide this contempt case. So this second contempt case will probably not be heard by Rohington, Fali Nariman and Vinit Saran. It will be heard by an appropriate bench, specially constituted by Chief Justice of India to hear this. So now the arena just got bigger. The arena just got bigger. The number of people who are accused of contempt got, it spread to four persons here, not just Mathews Nedumpara. And the judges who will hear, again, not just Rohington, Fali Nariman and Vinit Saran, it will be a different bench. So more judges coming into the mix. Therefore, more actors coming into the whole drama, shall we say. Okay, here is the letter that was sent by Bombay Bar Association and Bombay Incorporated Law Society. This is the whole thing. I'm going to upload this whole thing in the description below this video, And you guys can click on the link and download and read this, study this order. My assessment of it is that it is a very interesting sequence of events. And well, it's not going to die down quietly. That is my assessment of it and my own personal feelings about this whole thing. I have already revealed in other videos. I'm not going to repeat that here. I'm going to, of course, make more videos about this matter. So this is the Suo Moto petition CRS number 1 of 2019. What is this order? The order given is the punishment aspect of the contempt which was committed in the face of stands disposed of. So this is the order. The punishment aspect of the contempt which was committed in the face of the court stands disposed of. Given two complaints filed, it is clear that scandalous allegations have been made against the members of this bench. We therefore issue contempt, a notice of contempt to Vijay Kurle, Rashid Khan Pathan, Nilesh Ojha and Mathews Nedumpara. Given the serious nature of the allegations leveled against the bench, Chief Justice of India to constitute an appropriate bench to hear and decide the matter on contempt case. Yes, so this is it. You can read it, you can by clicking on the link in the description below. Thank you guys, and until next time, this is Krishna Raj Rao.